Good evening, everyone. I am Vani Ramesh. I am a Bharatanatyam dance teacher from Northern Virginia. I am the director of Srishti School of Dance. First of all, I would like to thank IDEA for giving me an opportunity to take part in this educational series that has been happening since April 2020. During this tough and testing period for all, we pray to God to give us strength and endurance to face the world we are in now. I have chosen today's topic as Bhakti Traya. As you all know, there are Navavida Bhaktis and Navarasas. Navavida Bhakti according to Bhagavata Purana. What is Bhakti? It comes from the root word bhaj, which means to share. Lord Krishna in Bhagavad Gita says that it is a yoga. Swami Dayananda Saraswati says it means seva. Few noted scholars and seers say it is the religious approach to God or Supreme Reality, or it's faith, trust, truth, or a spiritual path of love. Yes. We interpret bhakti in our own ways and try to get peace of mind and a sensation of realization or oneness, the ultimate bliss, chinmayananda, with what or who we believe in as God. Bhakti is expressed in many ways. Singing and dancing are the prominent ones. In Bhakti school of thought, like Navavidha Bhakti, there are Navarasas too. As explained in Bhakti school, the Navarasas are Shanta, Hasya, Vatsalya, Adbhuta, Madhurya, Shoka, Viraha, Krodha, and Vismaya. In today's presentation, I have taken three rasas. That from this Navarasa, that is, I have taken Hasya with a tinge of Adbhuta with it, Madhurya. I have included two different shades of Madhurya. One is Shringara Bhakti and Rati Bhakti to some extent, and Vatsalya. I'm trying to demonstrate with these emotions through Abhinaya. Also, I have chosen songs from the three time periods that are from 11th, 12th century, 15th, 16th century, and 20th century. It all is in Kannada language. The songs I have chosen are all commercial music. I tried my best to get the best ones out. All in Kannada language, as I said. In Karnataka, we have both Hindustani music and Carnatic music that we practice. And along with that, there is one more genre of music, which is, we call it as Sugama Sangeeta or Bhava Gita. I have included that too. So there are three time periods, three rasas, and three different styles of music. So the underlying current is bhakti. So I gave the topic the name Bhakti Traya. I'll try my best to make it interesting. Hope you all enjoy. I will start with the 11th and 12th century period when Shaivism was prevalent in the society. In Karnataka, Shaiva Siddhanta was popularized by a community called Veerashaivas. The devotees wrote many vachanas, which means speeches or a verbal promise. They call themselves Sharanas, and their vachanas are composed in very simple Kannada language, yet have deep philosophical meaning and a thought-provoking and meaning which are very thought-provoking. Their doctrine was being Kayakave Kailasa, that is, work is worship, and Sharanasati Lingapati, which means the devotees are the wives and Lord Shiva is their husband. The devotees can be male or female. They are all served Lord Shiva as a wife. I am talking about 12th century, not the present day situation. Allama Prabhu, Basavanna, Akka Mahadevi, Channa Basava, Nagalambike are just a few to name from hundreds of Vachanakaras. Today, I have picked a Vachana of Akka Mahadevi for Madhurya Bhakti. Akka Mahadevi was a very beautiful woman married to a king. But like Andal and Meera, who believed Lord Narayana and Krishna as their husbands, she believed Lord Shiva as her husband. She became an ascetic, even renounced her clothes and covered her body with her hair. She has penned many vachanas in praise of Lord Sri Mallika, Channa Mallikarjuna, and showed or showered love on him. In this vachana, she says, "Oh sister, listen. I had a dream. In that dream, I saw a coconut placed on rice and betel nut, which are very auspicious. At the same time, I saw a handsome man with small curly locks of hair and a beard going around asking for alms. I wondered who it was. Then when I realized it was none other than my beloved Channa Mallikarjuna, I went behind him to hold his hand. But as I was about to, I woke up from my dream and came to reality." I only got this much of the song in the recording, but there is more to this. I'll just give a glimpse of what it is in the next stanza, but I don't think I'll be able to demonstrate that because I don't have the music. In the next stanza, she says, "He enamored me, my mind. He enjoyed my body. He accepted bliss in my presence. He was happy with me. And I was in union with him. I am the beloved of Channa Mallikarjuna." Now I am going to demonstrate a song, Akka Kelavva.
Letter E five. An effigy I found.
Like I said, I don't have the second stanza, but this comes under Madhurya Bhakti. Next vachana of Sharane Nagalambike is about Vatsalya Bhakti. She was the older sister of Basavanna, who played an important role in his upbringing. She sees Lord Shiva in his brother, child Basavanna, and she says, "Oh Basava, your face is so wide and bright that I can rest my head and forget myself. You are my voice, you are my speech. I hold you and kiss you with love. I don't think or feel that we are separate. We have astrological connections. I feel that I am your birth mother and you are my child, Basava."
Thank you. Basavani makasichi, basavani amalokya, basavana nanitti muttadi suvin, basava sangana basava divajetu, basava sangana basava lingajetu, basava sangana basava divajetu, basava sangana basava lingajetu. Basavani makasichi, basavani amalokya.
I hope you can all hear me clearly and the song clearly. Now I will move on to the next time period, that is 15th, 16th century era of Haridasa Bhakti movement. By this time, Visishtadvaita of Sri Ramanujacharya and Dvaita philosophy of Sri Madhvacharya were propagated extensively. Haridasas believed in Bhakti Yoga. They practiced Navavidha Bhakti diligently. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Smaranam, Vishnu, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atmanivedanam. They listened and sang the praise of their Aradhya Daiva. They treated him as their guest, their owner, their friend, and finally, they laid their heart and soul to attain salvation. When you get to the stage of treating God as your friend, then you take liberty, all the liberty, to tease, ridicule, blame, taunt, love, quarrel with him or her. Whereas in the previous 11th, 12th century period, we didn't find that much of Sakhya with God. It was more of Dasya Manobhava. This period, time period, we see an intimacy that developed with God and the devotee. It is Shraddha and Bhakti. There was no fear. It was pure love. Shraddha and Preeti Bhakti. In many Haridasa compositions, we see this Sakya Bhakti. Today, I have taken a Purandaradasa Devaranama in the Hasya Rasa, where the saint blames or he makes fun of Lord Vishnu for being deceitful in the guise of a woman. Inta hennanu nanellu kaanenu. Ayyo, no way. I have never seen a woman like you. I have never seen anybody like you. What an amazing presence of mind. When the gods and demons churned the ocean for divine nectar of immortality, you came as Mohini. With your charms, cleverly took the nectar from the hands of the demons and cheated them and fed the divine nectar to the gods and deceived them. Without conception, you bore Brahma in your womb. Again, there is another stanza missing from the audio I got. In that one, there is the story of Bhasmasura and Mohini also, where Bhasmasura, Mohini tricks and makes Bhasmasura put his hand over his head where he burns into ashes. So that I couldn't find, but whatever I have, I'm going to demonstrate. Purandaradasa says, what kind of a woman are you? And they call you Purandara Vithala? Ha! Huh. This can be called as kind of Nindastuti too. So, I'm going to demonstrate. Inta hennanu nanellu kaanenu.
Intha hemmano nanellu kaanenu, kontha kaani kaaniro. Intha hemmano nanellu kaanenu, kontha kaani kaaniro. Intha hemmano nanellu kaanenu, kontha kaani kaaniro.
Kaani kaani ro, kontha kaani kaani ro.
Sorry, I have to move my chair back and forth. After this hasya touch, next I have taken a devaranama, a very rare one, at least for me, is a lullaby to Lord Hanuman. He is addressed as Mukhya Prana. It is another name of Hanuman. This is a composition of Vadiraja, Saint Vadirajaru. Lullaby to you, O Mukhya Prana. You are the name that is chanted repeatedly, even by the people who resent you. You are kind to the people that are your enemies. O learned one, you followed the path of celibacy, ruled the Vanara clan, adorned with pearl earrings and chest shield. You are at the service of anyone that come to you in utmost devotion. As the valorous Bhima, we have to know that Bhima is believed to be the incarnation of Hanuman, and in turn, Madhvacharya was born as an incarnation of Hanuman, that what we believe in. As a valorous Bhima, you came and destroyed Kichaka. You made sure that you kept your promise that you made to Draupadi. You are personification of eternal joy. You are the beloved of Hayavadana. Hayavadana is the pen name of Saint Vadirajaru. Come, sleep. I know you will be chanting the name of Sri Hari in your heart when you are sleeping. A lullaby to Lord Hanuman.
ಕವಚ ಪಂಚಕುಂಡಲಧಾರಿ ಪೂಜಿ ಪರಪಾರಿ ಪೇಸು ಜನರ ಉಪಕಾರಿ ಓ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಯೋ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಭೂವಿಭಾರವನು ಇಳಿಸಿದ ಭೀಮಾ ಕಾಮಿಕಿ ಚಕನ ಉತ್ತೀರ್ಣರಮ ಭೂವಿಭಾರವನು ಇಳಿಸಿದ ಭೀಮಾ ಕಾಮಿಕಿ ಚಕನ ಉತ್ತೀರ್ಣರಮ ಭಾವಿನಿ ದ್ರೌಪದಿ ಕಷ್ಟ ನಿರ್ಧೂಮ ಕಾಮಿತಾರ್ಥವ ನೀವ ಕಲ್ಪತರು ಧೀಮಾ ಯೋ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಯೋ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಣ ಸೌಂದರ್ಯ ದೂಪದ ಶ್ರೀಮದಾನಂದ ಕಂದೆಹಯವದನನ ಮೋಹದ ಕಂದ ಸೌಂದರ್ಯ ರೂಪದ ಶ್ರೀಮದಾನಂದ ಕಂದೆಹಯವದನನ ಮೋಹದ ಕಂದ ಬಂದು ಉಡುಗೆಯಲ್ಲಿ ನೆಲೆಯಾಗಿ ನಿಂದ ವಂದಿಸುವೆ ನಿದ್ರೆಗೈ ಹರಿ ಧ್ಯಾನದಿಂದ ಯೋ ಮುಖ್ಯ ಪ್ರಾಣ
Finally, I come to the contemporary period. As I told you earlier, in Karnataka, we have Sugama Sangeeta, a genre where we take the poems of the famous poets and then sing it with semi-classical music. I have chosen two songs for Madhurya Bhakti, one as Shringara Bhakti and the other one as a little bit of a Rati Bhakti in it. And the last one is a folk song, Janapada Geeta, very popular in Karnataka for Vatsalya Bhakti. Now I'm going to do a poem, Alisu Krishnana Kolalina Kare, is a poem taken from a Kannada musical ballet, Gokula Nirgamana, written by Sri P.T. Narasimhachar, also popularly known as Putina in Kannada literary world. The song is all about how the cowherd maidens of Vrindavan imagine Lord Krishna around them all the time. The sound of his mellifluous flute, which drifts them away to a world of pure love and devotion. This attraction distracts them from doing their daily chores. They even forget to wear what they had to after their shower. Yet they feel the pleasure of being with their beloved Krishna. When they hear the flute sound, it is just like the mind or the heart feels that all the darkness in their heart, sad, the down moments in their life will be gone, just like the first ray of sun takes away the darkness of night. Alisu Krishnana kolalina kare. Next, I have taken a song that depicts the feeling that comes in Rati Bhakti. This is taken from a collection of poems in Kannada called Antahpura Geetegalu by Sri D.V. Gundappa, who is also known as Sri D.V.G. He has written this on Shilabalikas of Sri Channakeveshava temple located in Belur, Karnataka. A sculpted maiden, Muraja Modini, is depicted holding in her hand a muraja, a kind of percussion instrument. In this song, the friends ask Muraja Modini, "What is the secret behind your cheerful and invigorating mood? You seem to suffer with loud pangs as Manmatha showers his arrows at you. Is this all because of Lord Channakeshava? He is calling you from the corner of his eyes to come and spend a night with him? Oh, tell me, dear friend. Yeni Mahanandave. Now, I come to the last song of today's presentation. This is a folk song. Actually, it's a folk song, but nobody knows it is. I don't think some of you know that it is. Even Karnataka people know that this is a Janapada Geeta, but it is used in a Kannada movie that has given popularity to this song. This is for Vatsalya Bhakti. The movie came in 1960s and it is sung by P. Sushila. I think Southern South Indians are familiar with P. Sushila. Here, the mother is calling her child to eat first and then go and play. She says, "Pure butter and ghee are waiting for you to be relished. I have to give you a shower first because it's your birthday. I will dress you up nicely and I have gifts for you too. So please come. It's getting late." Undada bahudu odi bayanna. Thank you. Presentation of Bhakti Traya. I hope you have all enjoyed the songs taken from the three time periods of three different Navarasa emotions and three different styles of music, all in Kannada language, and the song music popularized in Karnataka state. I enjoyed this presentation. I hope you all enjoyed as much as I did. I once again thank IDEA, especially Shruti Mukund and Krishna Veni Gurappu for all the help and support and giving me a platform. I've danced after many, many years. Thank you so much. I would like to thank my student Preeti Ramamurthy for editing the music. And last but not the least, I would like to thank you all who are watching, making time on a Saturday evening. I know there is nothing else going on in our lives, but still, you made time to watch my presentation. I'm so humbled and I'm so grateful to you all. Thank you so much. A pure heart and Shraddha will lead us towards Bhakti. So let's pray and hope this hard time shall pass and there will be new beginning for all of us. Namaste and Shubharatri. Sorry. Krishnaveni, Shruti, what do I do now? I just end the video. Thank you all. Thank you so much for your support. I'm reading all your comments. I hope I can save all this and cherish throughout my life.
Awesome.
Hello? I can end? If you want to save, yes, right? It said if you end the live video now, you will be able to choose if you want to save or delete it.